keep smoking.
Talk Radio, we back in the mix.
Alright, so tonight's show, I want to talk about a couple of topics. I want to talk about the fear of rejection. I want to talk about confidence on tonight's show. And I want to talk about why you need to surround yourself with positive people. And this is in general, not just to the dating game, but this is just in general. And we're going to go into the truth about haters. So without further ado, let me switch it up right quick. You know what I'm saying? Let me switch it up. So listen. All right. Without further ado. We're just going to get straight into it. We're not going to take too long to get into the game that I'm going to be dropping on today's show. Oh, later on, I'm going to see if I can get both mics on the line. I didn't do a show to detail what happened with him and his date, so we're going to speak to him probably later on tonight. I might drop another show later on tonight detailing what his situation is, man. Let's see if I was right, man. I tell you, man. I know how the shit goes, man. I studied this game. This game is a religion. That's what y'all don't understand. So listen. We're gonna talk about the fear of rejection. And this is just with anything. This is just with jobs. This is with, you know what I'm saying, dating. This is with just anything, man. Rejection is a beast. Rejection is a beast. But see, you have to learn how to properly handle rejection. But first, before you learn how to properly handle rejection, you need to know what rejection is for. Like, you know, rejection is actually not a bad thing. Rejection is actually a pretty good thing. Like, you know, rejection, I've learned so much from rejection. I've been rejected a lot of times, but I've also been accepted a lot of times too. Now, when it comes down to, you know, rejection, you know, you have to be ready. Like, you have to be willing to take the L in any situation that you do. It's trial and error. You have to be willing to apply yourself and your services to any situation. But in this certain situation, we're going to talk about dating. And I'm going to talk to fellas a little bit more on this. Like, I'm going to talk to my fellas about this, you know, because, see, there's two types of rejection. You have direct rejection, and you have, you know, passive rejection. So with direct rejection, you know, if you approach somebody or you know, approach a girl and, you know, she's like, no, I'm sorry, I'm good, just take it. You know what I'm saying? Wayne Gretzky had one of the best sayings that I've ever heard. Wayne Gretzky said, you miss 100% of the shots that you do not take. And it's true. You know what I'm saying? The shots that you don't take, you miss 100% of them. So, let me get into the game a little bit. Hold on, I want to spit. I really want to spit about this shit. Like, y'all gotta give me a second. Hold up. Let's get into the game. There we go. All right, so listen. Let me switch it out real quick. Okay, so listen. You miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. So when you approach, you know, female, you know, and she says no, that's not a bad thing. You see, you upgrade yourself because you get the reference points of actually talking to her. You see, when you talk to a whole bunch of different females, what you're doing essentially is, you know, you're taking a chance. You're taking a risk to get at, say, certain female. And when she tells you no, that's not always a bad thing, because see, with rejection, it's a safety curve, because you have no business getting with every female that you want, or every female that you talk to. You see, when you approach somebody or go for a job interview or do something, you're doing what's called applying yourself. So when you apply yourself to a situation, a lot of times you will get rejected. Everything that you think about is not true. You see, your mind will play games on you. Your mind will give you 101 reasons why not to talk to this female, because say, oh, maybe she looks mean, maybe she, you know, maybe she's probably beautiful, and she probably have a whole bunch of guys approaching her that night. You don't know, you know, you see what I'm saying? You really don't know what the deal is. See, your mind is a tool, you know, and I stress this a lot, you know what I'm saying? You know, your mind is meant for safety, fellas. So, you know, and this comes from the caveman era. You know, back in the day when you talk to a girl in the caveman era and she was claimed, you would get your head hit with a rock by another dominant male. See, that's still ingrained in us. So a lot of times your mind is designed to talk you out of certain things, and that can be really detrimental to getting the things that you want. You see, everything that you want is right outside your comfort zone. So what happens is, when your mind says, okay, this girl might be mean, and you go up and talk to her, you know, you don't know if that's the truth unless you go up to talk to her. You see what I'm saying? She might be the sweetest person. She just probably got a mean, you know, facial expression. A lot of girls with mean facial expressions are actually cool females when you talk to them. So, you know, your mind is not always right about certain things. Sometimes it is. Sometimes, you know, it's right, and sometimes it's not. But it's the fact that you took the risk to do something. You see, rejection is not a bad thing. You see, you're not meant to be with every woman that you approach. And everything that you want is not always right. And see, what it's doing is it's curbing you and leading you to the right place. So when it comes down to, you know, the fear of rejection, you need to be testing this fear on the daily, because it will never go away. So what you want to do is you want to keep it at, you know, a minimum. Because, you know, when you keep it at a minimum, you know, you'll get more results in the things that you want. You know, some girls aren't worth your time dealing with. You know, some girls are time wasters. And a lot of time wasters, what they do is that they send you on the runaround and you still don't get what you want in the end. You done wasted your money. You done wasted your resources. And, you know, it depletes you of your energy. Like, you know, you could have been doing something else with that time. So rejection is not a bad thing. Rejection is a safety curve. If she tells you no, and you're a guy that's, you know, that's worth being interested in, whose loss is it? That's her loss. See what I'm saying? She doesn't get reference points by telling you no. You can just say no just off impulse. You see what I'm saying? So I need you guys not to fear rejection. Rejection is not a bad thing. Rejection is actually a safety curve. Some girls you have no business dealing with. Some girls, you know, they're out of your league. They're gonna tell you no. Some girls, they have a boyfriend. Some girls, they don't. Rejection is a gift. It's a jewel. And it will lead you to the girl that you want in the situation that you want. A lot of times when women reject you, they're not rejecting you at all. They're only rejecting your approach. You see, when you approach a female, she doesn't know you. See what I'm saying? Your intent is to get her to know you. So, the thing about that is that a lot of females will reject you, but if she knew you, she wouldn't have rejected you. So a lot of times they'll reject you and then you'll do something or take on an endeavor and she didn't know the side of you. So, you know, you have to make sure that you're showing her a good side of you on your best behavior. You're doing, you know, you're doing you and you're showing her how you really are. That's what first dates are about. Show her what you are about. And if she fucks with you, she'll rock with that. You never get rejected. Your approach does, for the most part. See what I'm saying? The only reason why you're around a female is to show her who you are. That's what you should be around her for. See what I'm saying? And this ties into the second topic, which is confidence. The feeling of confidence is not going to come to you if you're not doing things that you want to be confident about. You have to really be plunging yourself and be doing something all night. So, if you want to be confident at approaching women effectively, you have to be out there approaching women all night and all day in multiple situations. And when you do this, this will breed confidence because you've done it a lot. Sometimes, without you noticing, you'll roll up on a girl really smooth, hit her with the game, step off, got the number, or you're on an instant date with her. So you have to know that the feelings of confidence don't come till later because, you know, you're always doing something. With this radio show, for example, I wasn't too confident with starting this radio show. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I was I'm jumping into podcasting. I'm jumping into putting certain things out there. But nigga, once you 60 episodes in and don't realize it, nigga, the shit gonna come with it. Same thing with women. You want to jump into this dating game. You want to have women. You want to, you know, be the type of guy to understand the type of lady that you want, so you can have, you won't deprive the lady of your dreams out here of being with you and having kids and having these great relationships, because, you know, you're the creator of this shit. As a man, when you plan out a date and all this other stuff, when your girl says, "Oh man, you're just so great," you know what I'm saying? And we click and, you know what I'm saying, we have great conversations and we do this, that, and the third. You know that you are responsible for all of that shit. You are responsible for your lady's image of you, or whoever you're dating image of you. They're going to think whatever they're going to think. But once you open your mouth, they're going to form a different opinion of you. And you need to make sure that your mouthpiece is crisp so that they can understand where you're coming from and kind of get onto the right of, the, you know, get onto the right track of who you are. And you allude them to certain things about you. You need to be playing chess and you need to not be playing checkers. You need to understand what you can offer and what you bring to the table, so people can know where you're coming from and can understand you as a person. You need to be about you, but you need to know about you. You know, on the last show, I talked about, you know, what are five things that you know that you can offer a woman. You need to be able to answer these questions really swiftly. See what I'm saying? Because a lot of these broads out here, man, they want the same shit. But they don't understand it. You know what I'm saying? A broad off the top is not going to say, "Okay, I'm dealing with this. this guy and I'm getting loyalty from him. But until you show her that, you know what? There's other women out here, but I'm only fucking with you. You have to make women understand you on a visceral level. A visceral level. Visceral. Look up the word visceral. Visceral is a natural thing. She has to naturally understand you. And you need to be confident. When she knows you know your shit and you know what you're doing and you know what you're talking about, she'll be more reluctant to listen to you. That's one of the big things, man. A lot of women hear their man, but they don't listen to their man. And this is on first dates. This is just in general. Some of these girls you're going to be going on a date with are in relationships. I am telling you, or they're waning themselves off of relationships, fellas. They have a man around them that they have listened to, but he fell a little bit short of the shit that he's saying. So they're searching for something new. And when they're searching for something new, you need to take her attention and know how to guide her attention in the direction that you want it to go. Am I getting too deep? You just need to be sure of yourself, and you just need to be a leader in, you know, in anything that you're doing. Like, I don't know, man. Maybe I gotta go into, you know, a different mode, or, you know, just a different way to, you know, explain this shit to you guys, because I really don't understand, because, you know, a lot of you guys just don't y'all don't get certain shit. I'm being dead serious. Y'all don't get certain shit. So this is the thing, man, with this radio show and just the people around you. You know, you need to surround yourself with positive people. You need to surround yourself with positive people and positive information. And this is just with anything. So let me switch it up, because I wanna talk about some other things. Like, speaking of surrounding yourself with positive information, we're gonna get back on surrounding yourself with positive people. We get into some real shit. Oh, okay, man. I wanna talk about surrounding yourself with positive information, man. You need to surround yourself with positive information, okay? I put out a show on the missing girls in DC. Okay, I want to talk to black people in general about this shit that I'm about to break down to you right the fuck now. Listen. You need to learn how important black media and all black news outlets are to the black community, or just to you in general, when it comes to terms of receiving information. You see, I can be on here all day and be telling you big words and you really don't understand what I'm saying, but your interpretation of what I'm saying dictates how you receive information. You understand what I'm saying? The things that I put on here, you know, dictates how you receive information. So when you mess with certain media outlets like Fox, and, you know, I mean, I know I did certain clips from Fox and stuff. Or, you know, just certain media outlets that you go to for your daily news. You have to understand the type of news that you're getting is going through 15, 14, 13 different people. It's getting edited and it's getting presented to you in a certain way. And when it gets presented to you in a certain way, you interpret it and think a certain way. The real important reason why it's good to listen to shows like this is because you need to be able to talk to common people like me and you, the layman or the average civilian that's in the trenches of what's going on certain situations, to receive the real about the type of news and information that you're getting. When you go to all these media outlets, what it does is that they will put information in your head to make you want to riot or make you be outraged about certain things or jade the way that you see things so that you respond in a certain way or that you see or understand things in a certain way. So you need to know the importance of receiving news from a black media outlet being a black person, because they will give you misinformation and you will not know and you will not be up to date on what's really going on locally or worldwide or internationally. You don't know what the fuck's going on in Africa until you go over to Africa and really see what's up and talk to Africans and see what they're saying. No, this is what's going on, not the shit that they're telling you. Actually, shout out to Sanaa Lathan. I'm actually about to play a clip from TMZ. TMZ is one of a I'm off and on with TMZ, but they do put out a lot of misinformation. But let me let you guys listen to something that, you know, Sanaa Lathan said, and this is pretty true. And I applaud our sister Sanaa Lathan for saying this. So take a listen. Let's get into this clip real quick, man. Let's get into this clip.
Forefront.
Finally.
Why do you think it took so long for people to start paying attention?
I mean, that's part of our, you know, the conditioning of our country, unfortunately, with the press. There's been a certain type of race that gets all the attention, and now finally, thank God, because of social media, people are, you know, saying, you know what, we're all Americans, all races. There's pain that happens in every community, and we, you know, we have to look out for all of us.
Do you think that the press will... Like, do you think this will just be kind of a temporary spotlight on the issues and then the press will slowly back off? Or do you think this will kind of make a permanent difference in the way the press covers these types of issues, you know, for all colors and creeds?
I hope that it makes a permanent difference. I'm going to be positive and hope that some real change is going to happen. Because of social media, it's like now, you know, we're going to be heard.
Yeah.
That's one of the positives. There's a lot of negatives about social media, but one of the positives. Oh, wait. I gotta go.
Okay. Thank you, Sanaa. We really appreciate it.
So that was our sister, Sanaa Lathan. Do y'all think what she said is real? Or not? So, like I was saying, You need to understand how you receive information. Same thing, fellas and ladies, with this game that, you know, me and my co-hosts are on here, you know, that we drop. Go back and listen to all my episodes, man. You wouldn't be having the problems that you do right now if you didn't listen and support. I'm being dead ass. So you need to surround yourself with real information, and you also need to surround yourself with positive people. The truth about hating and haters and you, when you don't surround yourself with positive people, you will have haters. And haters come in all types of forms and all different kind of ways and fashions, like, you know, that they will hate on you. Surround yourself with positive people. You know, a lot of people that you grow up with, I'm just going to talk about people that you grow up with in general. A lot of times, they will hate you. But just people in general that you know, that don't like you, they will hate you. But this is the thing. But I'm going to talk specifically about the people that you grow up with, why they will hate you. But this same rule applies to people that don't know you that will hate you. When you grow up around certain people, they figure, or people think that they know you. They figure that they know you when they don't really know you. You see, respect is admiration and fear. When somebody respects you, they admire you to the point that they fear you because they understand you and they know what you're capable of. So when you grow up with people around you and, you know, you start to do your own thing, they have to respectively know that, you know what I'm saying, that you're doing your own thing. So when people start hating on you, what happened is they use their ego. You know, in America, and I'm going to touch on this, you know, in future shows, because you probably won't understand what I'm saying. In America, it's our perception of equality. When people believe that they're equal to you, and you find some type of success in your life, they're going to start hating on you. And the reason why they're going to start hating on you is because if they really truly feel that they're equal to you, if they don't respect what you're doing, if they really truly feel that they're equal to you, they have to explain to themselves why don't they have the shit that you have. You see what I'm saying? So when people feel that they're equal to you and they don't have the shit that you have, how do you explain that? So how do you explain that to yourself? When you're out here struggling and trying to make ends meet, you're in a comfortable position. You're in a comfortable position. People know, okay, well, that's Chris. He has a, you know, a Crown Vic, and you know what I'm saying? He's going to work and he's doing this, that, and the third. He, you know, he's in a comfortable position. But once, you know what I'm saying, you get the Wraith or something, you get you a Rolls Royce or something, or you hustle enough and get you something, or you get your fame, or your, you know, stuff like this, people will hate you for small shit. It's because they have to explain to themselves why don't they have the shit that you have. And your peers and people around you will be the first ones to hate on you. So this is why you need to surround yourself with people that want to see you do good. You want to surround yourself with people that don't hate on you, or the things that you do, or the knowledge that you have on certain topics. You want to surround yourself with people that understand you and help you, you know, achieve your goals. You can't be surrounding yourself with people that hate you, because what they do is they become dead weight. And when they become dead weight, you sink with them. You see what I'm saying? You need to be in a position where you have people around you where you can grow and you and your hustle can flourish. Because the people closest to you are going to hate you for no reason at all. And when they can't prove, you know what I'm saying, they're going to start slandering you. They're going to say, oh, well, this nigga, he's with the Illuminati or some shit. This is why he has what he has. Instead of saying that you actually buckled up your boots and strapped yourself up and worked hard for the shit that you had. You see what I'm saying? So when people hate on you, you know, you need to learn how to turn that into motivation. You're doing something right. You're going in the right direction. But see, people are going to hate on you because they feel that they're equal to you and they should have the same shit that you have. It gets deeper than just hate. A lot of times people are hating you, they're really fans, to tell you the truth. So that's tonight's show. Make sure you understand that the fear of rejection is natural. Make sure you understand how important it is to have confidence in what you want to do and in the shit that you do. Make sure you surround yourself with positive people. And make sure you understand people that's hating on you and why. You know, studying people that's hating on you and why they're hating on you will make you understand your hustle on a whole new level. Some real shit. So check out the shit that I kick. Share the show if you fuck with the information. Check out my new single, All There. real shit. It's the kid, Young Kuda, man. I'm on the ones and twos, man. I am out of the building. I'm gonna try to hit up both mics, and we're gonna go over Mike's dating situation to see if she fell through or not. Fan Talk Radio. I fought it there. Can't believe me. Count it, I don't care.